We often assemble sophisticated things, but if wrong materials are used, then it causes accelerated corrosion and leads to the failure of the device.
Hello, my name is Maido and I am a material scientist specialized in nanotechnology. And today's topic is galvanic corrosion. Corrosion, as you know, is the degradation of a material and it is generally a very slow process, but it can accelerate if wrong materials are combined.
As it was mentioned, galvanic corrosion is an accelerated form of corrosion as it is an electrochemical process that occurs when two metals with different electrochemical activity are in an electrical contact with each other. In this process, the more passive metal drives the corrosion of the active metal, and at the same time, the passive metal remains unharmed. The process would keep going on until the active metal is completely gone or the electrical connection between the two broken. Take a look at this example, where two dissimilar metals have been in contact with each other for a couple months. One part has clearly corroded, and at some point it no longer serves its purpose. Another example would be an aluminum frame that is connected with steel screws. Aluminum is much more active than steel, and thus the steel screws drive the corrosion of the aluminum frame. So if this construction would be closer to the sea, where we have lots of chloride in the air, then pretty soon the steel screws would start falling out, as the surrounding aluminum has corroded away.
But let's take a closer look why galvanic corrosion occurs.
When the two metals are in contact with each other and covered with an electrolyte, then the more active metal becomes anodic and the passive metal cathodic. As a result, different chemical reactions start taking place at the sample surface. At the cathode, water reacts with oxygen and hydroxide ions are generated. However, this reaction is only possible if it gets excess electrons from somewhere. And it does. These electrons come from the more active anodic metal. As the atoms are stripped from electrons, they become positively charged and highly reactive. Thus, they desperately want to find a partner to settle down. As a result, more stable compounds like oxides and hydroxides are created, and that's what we call rust.
You might think that this process takes place only if the metals are immersed into the electrolyte, but this form of corrosion also occurs very well in open air.
This is due to the fact that in microscopic scale the materials are always covered with a thin layer of water. Of course, the process is faster closer to the sea, where we have plenty of moisture and chloride in the air.
So, how to prevent galvanic corrosion?
Well, first you should take a look at the galvanic series and combine only those materials that have an activity difference less than 0.2 volts. You can find one of these tables easily from the internet. When you type into the search engine galvanic series in seawater.
If you cannot avoid using materials with different electrochemical activity, then somehow you need to prevent these processes from happening.
For that, you can apply a coating on the metals to block the compounds that would take part in the reactions. Another option is to add an insulating layer between the two metals, so that electrons cannot pass through it, and as a result, the reactions cannot take place.
My name is Maido, and you just learned more about galvanic corrosion. Be sure to subscribe and leave your comments and questions below.